I was 18. Just had my 18th birthday in March, and this was in May. Went for a drive, and I don't remember very much before, but I know they told me that the car hit a soft shoulder on the road, and I remember flipping, and we turned over into a ditch, and I don't know, it seemed like 8 times to me that I can remember. I just remember flipping numerous times. Life went on. It was hard at first. I think first time I remember being in the wheelchair, I was stuck against the wall and couldn't get away from the wall. And I remember the tears saying, and to the nurse, she said, "What's wrong with you?" And I said, "I can't move. I can't get off this stupid wall." "Yes, you can." She moved me over. She said, "There, now go." I think when I was first at Lyndhurst, when we had a trainer who was, we used to call him mat class and chair class trainer. So you get on the mat or you do exercise in your chair. And he always said to me, there was no such word as can't, you can't. Don't ever tell me you can't do this. You might not be able to do it today, maybe not tomorrow, but next year, next month, you will be doing it. You know, maybe modified, but you'll be doing it. And he drilled that into my head, and I've said that to my kids 1,000 times. Don't tell me you can't. There's no such word as can't. You can do it, you know. You might be unable not to do something, but don't tell me you can't. My daughter Rebecca, my son Gord, my husband is Jim. We've been married 48 years just a week ago. Yeah, so, and he's still around and kicking and good. Yeah, my kids have gave me 7 grandchildren. I have 9 great-grandchildren. Beautiful kids. I love them all. It started, actually, I joined the Hamilton Steel City Wheelers way back in 1967. It's a wheelchair club here in Hamilton. But then somebody said to me, "You should be in the sports because you're strong and athletic, whatever." So what sports, you know? And they said, "Come on, let's go to Mac, whatever." So then they got me a trainer after we went out to Mac. Graham Ward was his name. Put me under his thumb and taught me how to shoot the discus and the shot put and the club throw and get on the track and push. And he was very encouraging. He was my trainer for a couple of years. And from there we did the regional. We did the regional and then we did the national. And then from there, if you were chosen, you were lucky enough to go on to the Olympics. So. I believe I can fly. I believe I can touch the sky. I think about it every night and day. Spread my wings and fly away. I believe I can soar. One of my favorite memories was when I threw the club throw in Cambridge and actually set the world record. It was recognized as a world record and I have proof of it. It's no matter where you set it, as long as you're competing, they will challenge any records that are set previously to that. And mine broke the record. I don't know for sure how much, but I don't know if it's still standing. That was way back in 76. But first I know it starts inside of me. Oh, oh, if I can see it. Life's a dance, you learn as you go. But anyway, I'm involved with the wheelchair square dancing. I'm a caller for the square dancers, so I tell them where to go. Okay, say hi to your partner. I'm part of your corner. Element left the corner. What we'd like to do is have you come out. Come on out, join us. We'll put you in a wheelchair and maybe have somebody push you around the floor to do the dance. And then if you want to try on your own, we'll get you going. If you ask my husband, he would say he used to leave a note on the fridge to tell him when I was going to be out. And now he says to me, it's easier to read if you put a note on the fridge and tell me when you're going to be home, because you're not here very often. I just keep involved and keep busy. I do income tax. I've been doing income tax. Worked with H&R Block for 8 years, and I'm still doing it today on my own, doing my own business. So I'm working. You can't dwell on your something that you can't change. If you can't change it, then get on with it and do something about it, you know. In fact, I'm in a book that's called So Get On With It. Get on with your life and do something. And I mean, even complete quads can complete in something, in sports or whatever, you know. I think people need CPA because they need somebody there to explain to them life is not over. It's beginning in a new way. You need to understand that life goes on, and just that support there to tell you you can do this, or you can, there's help out there, you know. There's so many changes since way back when I had my accident. There was nobody there to talk to me or anything, you know, just that one instructor who said, you know, get off your butt and do it. I'm sort of a confidant with a lot of people from the club because I'm a friend to everybody. I'm very, very few. I don't think I have any enemies. Everybody seems to come to me, Sharon, can I talk to you? Can I talk to you? About whatever, whether it's personal, whether it's financial, whether it's whatever, you know. But that's me, you know. I always seem to make time to listen and be good to somebody else, because people have been good to me in my life, you know. I mean, if you can share that, it's called pass it on, you know. That's part of life. My grandkids are phenomenal. My daughter's son, when he was 17, did a story on me in school when he was in high school. It was called My Hero. And they had to do a documentary on their hero or whatever. And he come to me and he said, Nana, he said, I got to do a school project. And I said, yeah. And he said, I want to do it on you. I said, what's it about? He said, about his hero. I said, come on, Justin. I'm no hero. Yes, you are, to me. So he wrote this story. And at the bottom of it, he put, my grandma makes Superman look like Barney. To get us through this lifetime, all the good and bad. He's kind of a quiet man. I think he would be proud. He's always usually pretty proud. He doesn't quite understand a lot of stuff that I do or whatever, you know. But he'll say, yeah, go for it, you know. He was a truck driver all his life. Jimmy would say to me, you know, I'd say, I'm going out to do this or whatever. Do you want to come? No, it's okay. You go and you have a good time. So I've always gone and he stayed home. And I've always said, you know what? When we get older, we're going to be called Rock and Roll Grandma and Grandpa. Because you're going to be sitting in your rocker, and I'm still going to be rolling away. I think if you want to do something, and if you make up your mind to do it, you should go ahead and try, and it usually works out. I think it's great, you know, like, there is no limits to what people can do in a wheelchair. I always say the only thing I can't do is climb a set of stairs, or a ladder, you know, but give me anything else and I'll try it. I love to go boating, I love to go camping, I have my own van, and I love life. I always say to my kids, you know, when I'm gone, if you want to cry for me, go ahead, do it for one day, whatever, but get over it. I've had a great life. I've had a fantastic life, and I don't think anybody could ask for more, you know. Stolen moments are all we have. When it comes to no limits, it's all about attitude and having a positive one at that. Stolen moments before they steal away.